who is the assistant professor in Anna University, DD campus. And moreover, he is my professor here. I've been honored in telling that here. So let me read out his profile. To brief up his educational qualification, sir has completed his BE Civil Engineering from Pondicherry University in the year 2000. And he has completed his ME in Irrigation Water Management from Anna University in the year 2002. And he has completed his PhD in Civil Engineering Stream in the specialization of groundwater remediation modeling in the year 2015 and same Anna University. And to tell about this employment record, sir is having about 8 years as assistant professor in teaching cum research experience from Center for Water Resources, Department of Civil Engineering, Anna University, Chennai. And he is having 1.5 years experience as SRM at CWR in Anna University, Chennai. And he is also having 2 years experience as junior research fellow at CWR, Anna University, Chennai. And he is having 4 years of experience as project associate at Center for Water Resources, Anna University, Chennai. And so far, he has completed around 27 research projects and consultancy as well as. And he is having membership in 4 professional societies, that is in American Society of Civil Engineering. And he is a life member in Indian Association of Hydrologists. And he is a member in Indian Journal of Science and Technology too. And he is also a member in Indian Journal of Environment and Research. And so now it's time for us to enjoy the session. It will be a really wonderful session too. So please be benefited out of this lecture. Okay, now I leave it stage to welcome, sir.
Finally, headlines. So then you, if you take Heisenberg's equation as a full derivation from a top order, because that is one of the lengthiest derivation in fluid mechanics, Heisenberg's equation. So then you have to part of it easier. First you take the shear distribution, then you go for velocity distribution, then discharge and good form, then the mean velocity and good form, then you take the ratio. Then finally we will end up with the Heisenberg's equation, that is head loss, okay, for laminar. But one important thing is, we can use Heisenberg's equation only when the flow is laminar. Reynolds number 2000 here, the Heisenberg's equation is one. So whenever you use a particular problem, so in the problem, the Heisenberg's equation is one. Either you have to prove the flow is laminar, either before the problem, before the solution, or after the solution. Once you have a problem, at least you have to prove that the flow is laminar. If the laminar is laminar, you can use the problem. Okay, if the flow is not laminar, okay, the turbulent transient, then you have to go for Darcy physics. So in the Darcy physics equation also, you get HF from the head loss due to friction. And in the Heisenberg's equation, you get again the head loss due to friction. So the derivation is lengthy, but you have to have to practice 2 or 3 times. So there is no short way to reproduce the derivation. Okay. So some of the things you can understand from the derivation. Maybe I'll lock up while I can give you the biggest advantage of the presentation. So minor loss, major loss, again I'll cover that. Heisenberg equation, we'll try to do that if time is there. Any other topic? Model studies, somebody called model studies. Model studies is a very interesting subject. Mostly you do it in hydraulic power plants or in any models. Okay, if you want to produce the model of this entire building, okay, or the entire campus, you need to have models. Somebody can use it for aeroplanes or in ships, okay. Mostly in mechanical engineering. And some cases like, you know, in mechanical there are some downscaling models also. I'll tell you what is downscaling or downscaling. So any other topic? Boundary layer.
So the hydraulic engine is
sum of the pressure energy plus kinetic energy plus total energy or potential energy. So the sum of these three energies called as a total energy. And when you take any pipe, okay, like if you take any pipe, so if you tap a point here, okay, so there will be a total energy line. Total energy of this particular point. Similarly, you have a number of points you can take, and you can at this each point you can mark a total energy point. Okay? If you just connect all the points, then that is called total energy. From the total energy line, if you subtract the kinetic energy, that is V2 by 2G, then you get hydraulic energy. So total energy line is V2 by 2G, kinetic energy but subtract. So finally, you get hydraulic field. Okay. Next. So in the diagram, so A is the one reservoir, B is the another reservoir. So we are connecting A and B to three different diameter pipes. Okay. So one is larger diameter, that the last is B1, and the next pipe is smaller diameter, the last is B2, and the next is the diameter little higher compared to the other two, this is B3. So the length of velocity is adding up, V1 adding up, V2 adding up, V3 adding up. Inga adding up. So V2 adding up because the diameter is smaller. But the discharge is inga discharge adding up. V1 discharge adding up, V3 adding up. Discharge cumulative was same as up. Every solution. First first pipe pullar for discharge na second pipe ku pogum anga pora pipe na third pipe ku anga pora discharge na third pipe ku varum vera inga the discharge aadada third pipe ku first vara pipe vara discharge ku same discharge goes to second pipe and the same discharge goes to third pipe also. So the first 1 2 3 all three pipes have the same discharge. So you know the continuity equation, discharge equal to area and velocity equal to AD. Okay. So discharge is constant on all three pipes. So when you change the area, get the area out. The equation rent with the constant in full time. You know another area out. If Q is constant, the area is changing, one is diameter, one is smaller diameter. So after where has it changed out, the velocity will change. That's why the velocity will change. So the first time, you can take it from A, so that is the first time it's hydraulic gradient line. Total energy is the top one, and below that we have a minusing V2 by 2G in all the pipes. We get the hydraulic gradient. Point the point. So how to draw this? How to draw this? Because we may have some problem. Some problem. Hydraulic gradient line, total energy line, or anything. First, we have to take the level of reservoir at A. That is the first point. Then you redial the inlet glass. Okay, HI inlet glass. I tell you what is the inlet glass. So then you direct, then you come the degree downwards. Then you have to draw a horizontal line, that is daughter line. So from the daughter line, you have to minus the HF1. HF1 is the friction losses for the pipe 1. Okay, other minus point. Then you have to connect the inclined. So from that we have a contraction, because diameter is getting decreased, there you get a contraction loss. So under the contraction loss is 0.5 V2 by 2G. You can go downward. You can from there there is a HF2. Okay, so we have an inclined line. From there it is expansion. Because smaller diameter to larger diameter, we have an expansion loss. So the expansion loss V2 minus V3 by 2G. And then we have a V3 loss, that is HF3 loss. Okay, again we have inclined line, and finally it ends up with the reservoir. Okay, then we have an exit loss. Exit loss is HR, which is from pipe 3 to the reservoir B, that is exit loss. If you minus the exit loss, then it will merge with the water level of the reservoir B. Okay. So from the water level of the reservoir A to B, you can get the okay. So then from the total energy line, you detect the V2 by 2G component, then you get the answer line. Okay. So, in the so first V1 square by 2G per cell gap, the similar, the gap between V2 square by 2G will be per cell. Yeah? Yeah, gap per cell.
இருந்தது வெலாசிட்டி அதிகம் இருந்ததால v ஸ்கொயர் பை 2g காம்போனன்ட் v1 ஸ்கொயர் பை 2g காம்போனன்ட் கூட பெருசா இருக்கு தட்ஸ் வை கெட் தி பிகர் டைம் ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் சோ தி மேஜர் லாஸ் பாத்தீங்கன்னா தேர் இஸ் ஒன்லி ஒன் லாஸ் ஓகே தட்ஸ் பைப் லாஸ் ஓகே when you have a pipe so whatever the flow takes place there is going to be velocity you calculate what is the loss taking place through the pipe so மேஜர் லாஸ் வந்து only the pipe loss okay minor losses are all other losses like we have a inlet loss exit loss then contraction then the change in diameter okay so contraction from larger diameter to smaller diameter expanded diameter smaller diameter to larger diameter expansion okay then any obstructions okay so everything is called as minor losses also other fittings like gate valve okay so when you want to regulate the flow okay, or some pressure relief valve so there also there will be some losses or some joints coupling okay or some bends elbow 90 degrees bend okay or u bend okay so there are bends and t bend okay so like that also there will be some losses okay when you make so these are the losses are called as minor losses okay so minor loss why we call as minor loss major losses major loss magnitude wise larger minor loss the magnitude wise smaller so what are the losses magnitude wise smaller we call as minor loss what are the losses magnitude wise bigger okay in comparatively we call as minor loss so this is the basic classification why we call as minor loss we call as minor loss because the losses are higher that is minor loss so the so normally we use Darcy-Weiss equation or you can use Stages formula also so mostly we use the Darcy-Weiss equation in pipe flow but we can use Stages formula also but Stages formula you will mostly use it in open channel that's it and we have assembly and also in pipe so this is Darcy-Weiss equation let's take a pipe the diameter of the pipe is same okay. and there are two sections I'm taking that is based on the IRS approach okay section 1 and section 2 Section 1 I take the pressure as P1 and section 2 I set the pressure as P2 and then between the section 1 and 2 is capillary. So there is a pressure force will be acting on section 1 that is pressure force means pressure into area okay P1 into A okay. So that is one pressure force will be acting at the section 1 and section 2 there is another pressure force that is P2 into area of the pipe okay. So that then only you get force pressure force. Pressure is Newton per unit square. Multiply with area, you get the Newton. Okay, you get the force. So P1 and P2, you get two forces. And there are other forces because we are looking for the losses also. That means how much losses will take place on the surface or the inner surface of the pipe. Okay, that will take as the F dash. So the F dash is be taken as the frictional resistance offered by the pipe on the bottom. Okay, one flowing water. So normally we are always in the opposite direction. The frictional resistance will be always higher against the flow direction. So F dash is the frictional resistance per unit area and per unit velocity. So if you want to find what is the total frictional velocity resistance, so the frictional resistance F dash into the area into velocity. Okay. Then you get back, you can get what is the total frictional resistance. So we take the sum of the forces equal to 0 under equilibrium condition. Sum of the forces. So P1, A1 is from left to right side. We take positive. Okay, section 1. Okay, from left to right. And T2, A from right to left. So we take as a negative. So it goes to other side. Similarly, frictional resistance also again from right to left. One. So I think that also you are taking the other side. So now you take P1 minus P2 by into A. The frictional resistance you substitute the values of F dash in the area in the V power M. Okay. So now what is the area? Previously. So if you take the pipe and this is from section 1 and 2, so what is the area which contributes to the frictional resistance? What is the area of pipe which contributes to the frictional resistance? பைப்பர் ஃபுல்லாக தண்ணி போகுது எவ்வளோ ஏரியா வந்து ஃப்ரிக்ஷன் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் காண்டிருக்கும் பைப்பர் டயா டயா ஏரியா வந்து டயா வந்து ஏரியா இந்த பைடி ஸ்கொயர் பைடி ஸ்கொயர் போகுது கிராஸ் செக்ஷன் ஏரியா கிராஸ் செக்ஷன் ஏரியா இஸ் நாட் காண்டிருக்கும் முடியுதா? சோ ஃபிரிக்ஷன்ன்றது பைப்போட இன்னர் சர்ஃபேஸ்ல மட்டும்தான். கிராஸ் செக்ஷன்ன்றது இந்த சைடு ஃப்ரீ இருக்காது. ஒன்லி இந்த சர்க்கம்ஃபரன்ஸ் மட்டும்தான் உங்களுக்கு ஃபிரிக்ஷன் இருக்கும். இந்த நடுவுல தான் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் இருக்காது. நடுவுல தான் ஃப்ளோர். ஓகே சோ பை டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் திஸ் கிராஸ் செக்ஷன். சோ திஸ் இஸ் நாட் கோயிங் டு கான்ட்ரிபியூட். ஒன்லி த இன்னர் சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆஃப் த பை. சோ அது வந்து எவ்வளவு ஏரியா இருக்கு? அது எப்படி சர்க்கம்ஃபரன்ஸ் கண்டுபிடிச்சா பண்ணலாம். Then you have to take K in the formula. You can, again I can use pi d in L. Because if pi d is going full, then pi d L can only. Pi d L will be length full. But if the path is full, then you have to take only the half the area. Okay, or 3/4 or 1/4, okay, then based on that you have to take what is the area in which the water is in touch with the pi. Okay, so this is called the vector area. Vector area means, so flow or flow mode, in the area one, வெட் பண்ணிடும் வந்து தட் ஏரியா ஒன்லி ஹேவ் டு டேக் பிகாஸ் தட் இஸ் தட் ஏரியா ஒன்லி கான்ட்ரிபியூட்டிங் டு ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் அதாவது எல்ஏஆர் பாயிண்ட். சோ திஸ் இஸ் தி வெக்டர் ஏரியா எக்ஸ். ஓகே சோ தட் வை கால் தி டி இன்டு எல். ஓகே சோ திஸ் இஸ் டி இஸ் நதிங் பட் தி வெக்டர் ஏரியா. ஓகே நான் வெக்டர் பெரிமீட்டர் யூஸ் பண்ணேன். வெக்டர் பெரிமீட்டர் மீன்ஸ் இது பை டி க்ரோ இன் ஃபுல் இட் இஸ் பை டி. டேஸ் ஆஃப் தென் பை டி வெச்சு. சோ இன்டு வாட் இஸ் தி லெந்த் இன் விச் தி ஃப்ளோஸ் டேக் பிளேஸ். தட் இஸ் டி இன்டு எல். சோ தட் இஸ் ஏரியா of the resistant forces acting into b power n. So this b by a also called as a hydraulic mean curve, that is m, and p1 minus p2 by rho g is nothing but of the h. Okay. So p1 minus p2 by rho g, that is gamma. p1 minus p2 by gamma is nothing but of your h, that is hydrostatic equation, that is p equal to gamma h equal to p by gamma. So that is equal to p minus p2 equal to that is delta p. That's the difference in the so the previous equation you are dividing by rho g as gamma. Okay, then you equal the hf equal to p minus p2 by gamma. So you get hf equal to f dash by gamma into p by a into l b power m. So this a by p is the hydraulic mean radius or mean depth because that is gamma. Okay, so a by p you know this is 1 by m. Next slide. Right? So now we take that m equal to a by b, okay, assuming that the pipe is flowing full, we take the vector perimeter as the pi d, okay, vector perimeter as the pi d, okay, and a is nothing but the area of the pi. So the pi d square by 4 divided by pi d, you will get what d by 4. So the m is substituted as d by 4 and the n is 2 and is the value of 2. For that we want to understand what is 2, we have to go to Reynolds experiment. So Reynolds experiment is the question being one. Reynolds experiment. Okay. So the, how to say that? Okay. So if we plot, okay. So Reynolds did the experiment to understand how when the flow becomes laminar or when the flow becomes turbulent. Okay. So he put a, his own apparatus, okay, one more pipe or pump, and one dive on to it. So flow on the smooth earth more than the dive or thing again. So it will only go as a linear mixer. Okay, and the dive will not mix with the other water. Okay, so that, when it is not mixing, we call it a lamina. So when the dive mixes with the water, and the dive on the dispersed water, it mixes all the water. That means the water from one layer to another layer is going on. That means what is the problem. So that's how we made an experiment on that. And we made one more graph. Okay, the graph is between velocity with the gradient. Okay, that is HFYL. Okay. So just read the Reynolds experiment. Okay, this is done in any of the fluid mechanics. All of them are gone. So then you understand why it is true. Because in turbulent case, the rate is 1.2 only. The
cases la 1.7 la 2 varaikum irukum adu maximum value avu 2 nu vechikkom this is positive okay, that's it so the a enna endru neenga vechikkom so m equal to 2 nu eduthukom and m equal to d by 4 again just go you substitute in the original equation so then divide by 2g also you will get okay. So finally you get 4fcl d square by 2g என்ன டிவைட் பை 2g ல பண்ணனும் டிவைட் பை n 2g ல பண்ணனும்னா சோ எனி अदर லாஸ் எந்த லாஸ் அந்த பைப்ல ஒரு தண்ணி போகுது ஒரு லாஸ் னு வெச்சுக்கங்களே சோ கைனெடிக் எனர்ஜி தான் குறைக்கும் வந்து ஒரு வேகமா தண்ணி போயிட்டே இருக்கு லாஸ் அதிகமா இருந்தா கொஞ்சம் போறனே அந்த லாஸ் குறையும் தட் மீன்ஸ் எனி லாஸ் ஓகே இந்த இடத்துல பாத்தீங்கன்னா கைனெடிக் எனர்ஜி தான் லாஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சோ தட்ஸ் வை So we want to represent this head loss due to friction in terms of kinetic energy. The kinetic energy component d square by 2g over value of and the value control is on the d by 2g at the right one. Then that will be put in the 2g f that by comma that is called as a m. Okay. So that is called as a f that. Sorry, f. So 4f that means by 2g. So 4f equal to f1 at the one, the f1 is friction factor. ஃபார்முலா யூஸ் பண்றதுக்கு ரெண்டு இது இருக்கும் ஒன்னு ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஃபேக்டர் ஒன்னு இருக்கும் இன்னொன்னு கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஒன்னு எப்ப கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் யூஸ் பண்ணுமோ எப்ப ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஃபேக்டர் ஃபார்முலா யூஸ் பண்ணுமோ தெரியும் இந்த ப்ராப்ளத்தை கொடுத்தோம்னா ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஃபேக்டர் கொடுத்துட்டாங்க யூ ஹேவ் டு யூஸ் ஒன்லி எஃப்எல் டிஸ்கவர் டு யூ ஹேவ் 4 வரது கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் கொடுத்தாங்க அப்ப 4 எஃப் வரும் இந்த ஃபார்முலா யூஸ் பண்ணும்போது யூ ஹேவ் டு யூஸ் கால்குலேட்டர் இல்ல 4 டைம்ஸ் அதிகமா போறோம் இல்ல 4 டைம்ஸ் லெஸ் ஆகும் சோ தி ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஃபேக்டர் அண்ட் கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் யூ ஹேவ் டு யூஸ் கால்குலேட்டர் So that's how many which formula. Like the problem, they give friction factor as the value, then you have to use FL viscous being 2 dB, FL viscous being 2 dB, then it is coefficient of friction, there is 4 F. We can use the last row also. Okay. So to find the F value, this laminar flow you need 16 by RB, and in this turbine cases, you can use 0.079 by RE power 1 by 2. These two formulas you can use to calculate friction factor, okay? Not the Reynolds number. Don't use these two formulas for calculating Reynolds number. You cannot use it for Reynolds number. You can use only for finding friction factor. Next, the diagram for the Moody. This is called Moody diagram. Moody, M O O D Y. So Moody is a scientist. With this graph. So this mode, this is called Moody diagram. So it's not Moody. Okay. There are Moody names. Moody diagram. The purpose of the diagram is patina. So you can find the friction factor for the any given point. In the material as well, you can able to find the friction factor or curvature of friction for the particular point. Okay. That's all. மூணு ஆக்சஸ் இருக்கும் ஒன் எக்ஸ் ஆக்சஸ் ரெனால்ட்ஸ் நம்பர் தென் பிரைமரி ஒய் ஆக்சஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஆர்சிஸ் ஃபிரிக்ஷன் ஃபேக்டர் அண்ட் செகண்டரி ஒய் ஆக்சஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ரிலேட்டிவ் ரஃப்னஸ் ஸோ இதில் ரஃப்னஸ் என்னன்னா ரஃப்னஸ் என்னன்னு தெரியுமா ரஃப்னஸ் ரஃப்னஸ் என்ன
and from the Reynolds number you have to critically you have to go above and
these two intersect somewhere. I don't know, Radha by Mark Inaka, you get the friction.
Next. So the minor losses, sudden enlargement, the formula is there. And sudden contraction. So you can use K into B squared by 2G, but default condition you can take K equal 0.5. Okay. Sometimes the coefficient of contraction is when CC is given, then you have to calculate what is the K value based on the CC is 0.62, the K value is 0.375. So the 3.75 you have to use instead of K. Okay. So if CC is given, you have to use this, otherwise you can use 0.5. So there is a derivation for this.
Yeah.
take a whatever appear
first reservoir is A
and second reservoir is B and apply Dunard equation. How to apply Dunard equation? You have to write P A by rho G plus P 1 P A square by 2 G plus Z A equal to P 2 P B by P B by rho G. Okay, diagram alone. Then I think it's better than a point. Yeah, that is the part. Then I think it's better.
Some call consider only major loss. Some call
consider all the losses. Okay, then you have to consider both the losses. So, if you have any problem, you could be able to write what are the losses.
Okay. So, this is one reservoir. So, this is one reservoir. We have another reservoir. So, this is the water level. So, this is H. We have a pipe. So this is called A and this is called B. So when you write Bernoulli's equation, you have to write like P1 by rho G, or here you say PA plus VA square by 2G plus Z A equal to PB by rho G plus VB square by 2G plus ZB equal to plus HL. Okay. So this is, if the illanaka is on the real field. The component illanaka, HL illanaka, the real field. HL illanaka, sorry, real field, ideal field. Okay. Illanaka, ideal field. Ideal field is discussing the real friction. Real field illanaka is discussing the real field. Then we have a head loss also. So this HL means this is called a real field equation.
LPD. Okay. So the HL in the add panama. HL in the add panama. Let's get it. That is in doubt. So HL, yeah, I'm going to add something. I'm going to add something. Starting with ending from the last one. So ending with the last one. So ending with the last one. So pipe show வந்து first starting ல அது வரைக்கும் போகுது starting ல எனர்ஜி அதிகமா தான் இருக்கும் ஓகே போக போக தான் friction loss வரும் அப்ப total energy ல இருந்து ஒரு component friction loss தான் minus ஆகி போயிட்டே இருக்கும் so the end of the வந்து first ல எனர்ஜி அதிகமா இருக்கும் second ல last ல வந்து எனர்ஜி கம்மியா இருக்கும் so whatever the energy loss that we have to add in the downstream so the flow direction to a to b na இங்க add பண்ணுங்க இதே flow direction b to a னாக்கா இங்க add பண்ணுங்க flow direction ல லாஸ்ட் தான் அந்த இந்த ஹெட் லாஸ் ஆட் பண்ணுங்க flow direction ல லாஸ்ட் இனிஷியல் ஆட் பண்ணுங்க சோ தி பேரலல் ஈக்வேஷன் சோ ஐ ஆல்ரெடி செட் திஸ் இஸ் ஓபன் டு அட்மாஸ்பியர் சோ திஸ் பிகம் 0 அண்ட் திஸ் ஆல்சோ பிகம் 0 ஓகே வெலாசிட்டி இங்க இஸ் நாட் இஸ் ஸ்டாடிக் வாட்டர் சோ திஸ் ஆல்சோ பிகம் 0 இதுவுமே 0 சோ தென் யூ ஹேவ் இஸ் தட் ஏ மைனஸ் இஸ் தட் பி ஈக்குவல் டு ZA, ZB in another with respect to some data, what is height of this point A and what is the height of point B. Okay. Either I can make like this, this is data but longer the resistance over A minus this is ZB. Okay. Or I can take the data minus because I don't know what is the distance between this. So other order I take the data minus the bottommost point. So this is the data. I think this is the datum. So from the datum, find P over distance over. Find P over distance over. Pratama solution. Right, right. Yes, yes. Take it distance over. Find B on datum, then you have a line. Take it in here. B in the water level. I'm just taking the water level as the datum. அப்போ B யும் வாட்டர் லெவல் சேம் தான் அப்ப இஸ் தட் B டிஸ்டன்ஸ் எவ்வளவு டேட்டமும் வாட்டர் லெவலும் சேம் அப்ப இஸ் தட் B டிஸ்டன்ஸ் எவ்வளவு 0 சொல்லுங்க நான் இந்த தூங்கி தெரியுங்க இந்த வேற முடிச்சு இல்ல ஓகே சோ இஸ் தட் B இஸ் 0 ஓகே அண்ட் இஸ் தட் A இஸ் தட் A இஸ் H So for H minus 0 equal to HL. Okay, H equal to HL. So HL under the another, you have to add this. Okay, HI plus HF1 plus HE plus HF2 plus HC. HE plus HF3 plus HC.
where the minor loss varanaka, you can remove this minor loss component and you can have only this thing. That is the loss of the impact. So you have only major loss, minor loss are removed.
So in the problem put down, first diagram are again, okay, in the flow through bicycle, then apply try to apply the equation. Bernoulli's equation, Bernoulli's equation is the head loss of the control. Head loss of the control.
சம்டைம்ஸ் ரெண்டு மூணு ப்ராப்ளம் கொடுப்பாங்க. ஸோ ஒன் ரூபாய் இங்கே இருக்கும், இன்னொரு ரூபாய் இங்கே இருக்கும். சில ஒன்